Well, the story you're about to see may shake you up a little bit. Minnesotans likely know more about cold weather than people from other parts of the country. Mm-hmm. We pride ourselves on that.
Well, Minnesota winters cannot be taken lightly. One mistake can change your life. And our Ken Barlow has a story about a man who was not Minnesota ready.
It's a January night, the depth of a Minnesota winter. An icy wind driving down the temperatures. That's where Allan Schaefer's story begins.
Take me back to that night. Tell me how cold it was. Tell me what you were doing.
Allan was driving that night, and it was cold inside his car.
The front heat is the only part that went out. The back heat was still working.
Allan figured it was a blown fuse, and he figured he'd fix it himself. But
I didn't have hat or gloves because I was just traveling. I was coming back from St. Cloud, so I wasn't equipped to be outside.
But he did have space heaters.
Portable space heaters that plug into the cigarette adapter.
He had two space heaters and a plan.
Going back and forth between the space heater to keep my hands warm and checking a few fuses. It was 28 below zero and 53 below wind chill.
He gave up on the car and went indoors.
About 3 hours after I was inside, my hands swelled up, probably triple the size they are, and got water blisters all over.
Later in the emergency room, he found out why.
As soon as I walked in, they said, man, you have one of the most severe cases of frostbite we've ever seen.
He was rushed to HCMC's burn unit.
They said that going back and forth between the extreme of hot and cold will desensitize your hands so you can't feel temperature one way or the other, hot or cold.
Warming his hands actually contributed to freezing them because the heat thinned his blood.
I lost my pinky almost all the way, my index finger they had to take down to here.
So you actually lost more in the hand that you use most than you did on the left one.
Yeah.
At first, he thought he was going to lose more than that.
How am I going to live now? It's because I did carpentry and landscaping and that's kind of my livelihood. Mm-hmm. And I saw all that disappearing.
He says he thought he was prepared until he found out he wasn't.
You hear the stories about it, or your fingers are going to turn black and fall off. It's not how it happens. I didn't notice anything for several hours until it was too late.
At first, doctors thought that Allan would lose everything except his left thumb. The first hospital he went to wasn't equipped to deal with a case like his. That's why he was transferred to Hennepin County Medical Center's burn unit.